I am with the youngest veteran in town, everybody. You know who I'm talking about. You've been in the industry like at least 10 years.
Well, the first single came out 7 years ago.
And you're not even 23.
I'm not even 22.
Not even 22. Ladies and gentlemen, Beyonce. Beyonce Knowles.
Hello.
AKA lead singer Destiny's Child. AKA number one selling artist in the UK right now with the fastest selling album so far this year, week one.
It's crazy.
Simultaneously number one in America. It gets crazy. So this long wait for your album, which we've had for some time now, has been worthwhile.
Well, I definitely worked hard on it, and I was hoping people would enjoy it and accept it and understand it. Basically, it shows my growth, vocally as a producer, and just me evolving into a woman. And I love it so much, and I was nervous about Crazy in Love, people not quite getting it 100% because of the live horns, and it has this old school feel to it, but I guess people wanted something new. So I'm very, very happy with that.
Well, you gave us something new with the first single, which was a while ago for the Austin Powers soundtrack. I remember saying, I saw you that time, and I said, it doesn't sound like the biggest hit, but I understand the concept of it.
Right.
Yeah, I hope I didn't insult you by saying that.
No, not at all. I didn't care if it was the biggest hit. I wasn't trying to go for the biggest hit. I was trying to go for some different quality, good live sound to introduce my generation to that element that I heard growing up listening to my parents. You know, some people in America, especially the younger people, they don't know where these samples are coming from, and they haven't had the luxury of hearing people sing live with live bands, and I just wanted to bring that back.
It smacks of Aretha to me.
Yeah, Aretha, I love Aretha.
Franklin. It was real in the vein of an Aretha Franklin song.
Yeah.
And so your first single comes out, well, your second single comes out quite a while after, and you've lent a little bit on the go-go, Wash It and Go-Go sound in the middle there. That's where the horns and the percussion comes from.
How you know about Wash It and Go-Go?
Oh, come on, man, I know about you and all those. I love go-go, but go-go came and just went quite quickly in America, didn't it?
Yeah.
So that was your risk for you, wasn't it, like you say?
Definitely. It was a little bit of old school, which the last time people didn't get, and go-go, but I didn't care because I liked it. So.
Good for you, because people are really afraid to use horns in records now.
Yeah.
You know, you don't hear, when last did you hear a trumpet or a saxophone or anything in a modern R&B record? And this is the first record in quite a while, I think, we've heard it. And so you might start the trend.
Well, I hope so.
Okay, let's rewind a little bit, because when Destiny's Child, obviously you've been on MTV so many times with us, every time, at every stage of your career, thankfully you've come over and we've had a little chat. Mm-hmm. I mean, we could flash back to all the little chats we've had.
For that reason, I'm not even
going to
go there.
I walked into the record store and I said, the writing, what are they trying to tell me?
No, the writing on the wall is very clear.
Oh. Glad to be back.
Very glad to be back.
Doing your first show in London. Well, concert in London. And it's sold out, so you're excited?
Very excited.
Oh, God.
They're all good, don't worry. The nails getting done, you know. What else is it there?
Oh, I remember that.
Remember the nails getting done, the very first, the shows you did, the lick party and stuff like that. The Ministry of Sound is great. But when we knew you were going to go solo, and we knew the girls were going to, or you three girls were going to do your own solo projects, I wouldn't say the money was immediately going to be on Kelly having a massive hit with Nelly and Dilemma. And then stole. She did so well.
Yes, she did.
And I know you're very pleased for her.
I'm very, very happy for her.
But the pressure, in terms of the media and everyone, was Beyonce was supposed to be the one having those hits. are you honestly going to tell me at some point you thought, damn, I'm under pressure now?
Absolutely not.
Really?
My definition of success is not necessarily having a number one hit right now. I've written, I don't even know how many number one hits. I'm artistically, I want to grow and I want to do something different. I want to make quality music. I don't necessarily care about selling as many records as Destiny's Child or as anyone else. I just want to go on tour and sing music that I love and have fun on the stage and be creative. You know, we've sold 33 million records. It's nice to be number one. It's nice to sell records. Yeah. But I've already done that with Destiny's Child. And I did want to have a successful record. But like I said, my definition of success is a little different.
Writing your own stuff and you produce. A lot of people forget, I think, that you do all that because of your electrifying sort of stage performance. You know, they see Beyonce knows now, I think, as a star in your own right, but they don't assume that singers like yourself write your own material. Some people, do you ever get people interviewing you, for example, don't get that or remember that?
Yes, all the time. And it's very frustrating.
I can imagine.
Because I would much rather someone acknowledge that. I mean, I would love for them to acknowledge a great performance also, but people always want to say, oh, they looked hot in the video, or, you know, you looked great, or whatever. That's great, but that's not important to me. I want people to acknowledge my talent and me as a producer and a songwriter.